yung kamay, yung leeg, katapos.
Edgar Matobato says he and Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte have something in common. They both have blood on their hands.
Sa akin, ma'am, gusto kong pababayarin.
I want him to pay for what he did, for the many killings he ordered, he says. If we bring back the death penalty, I hope Duterte is the first to hang, and then I will follow. Decades before the president took his bloody war on drugs nationwide, Matobato says he was part of a group known in the Philippines as the Davao Death Squad. A 2008 UN investigation found the shadowy band of assassins was committing hundreds of murders in Davao, targeting street children and criminals, all during Duterte's decades-long run as the southern city's gun-toting, crime-fighting mayor, beginning in 1988. I personally killed around 50 people, Matobato says. He shows us a journal with names and dates of some of his victims, written by his wife because he can't read or write. Matobato also showed his Davao City ID. He says he was a ghost employee, earning just $100 a month to murder on command.
Who was ordering the death squad to kill all these people?
We got the orders from Mayor Duterte, he says. CNN cannot verify his story, but Matobato's graphic testimony in September before a Senate hearing on vigilante killings shocked the Philippines. The country's Human Rights Commission is investigating. The president's office says he changed some details in his story.
Very inconsistent. So if you go through the transcript in the Senate, you will see for yourself that Matobato is lying through his teeth.
The president's communications secretary, Martin Andanar, says if the testimony was credible, police would have built a case.
The Davao death squad that people are talking about, this is all legend. It's all legend. There's no death squad.
I did kill. I was only 3 months mayor.
Duterte told me he personally gunned down 3 people while mayor of Davao, to set an example for his officers. But in media interviews, he said he doesn't remember Matobato and denies ordering vigilante killings. For several years, Matobato was in official witness protection. Now that Duterte's president, he's just in hiding. We meet at a safe house several hours from Manila. He's moved at least 10 times in the last year and is currently facing charges of kidnapping and illegal firearms possession. I was told to cut the body parts into pieces, he says. Matobato claims they dump bodies in crocodile farms, in the streets, and even in mass graves. But those graves have never been found.
Why are you the only one who has come forward?
He says many of them are scared. If we try to change, we're killed.
So you think if they find you, they'll kill you?
They will kill me, he says, because now their secrets have been revealed. Matobato says he's eager to confess his sins, to shine a light on the dark reality behind the president's deadly drug war.